I got a comment on one of my videos asking me why I don't believe in hell, and I just thought of responding in a video instead of in a message. I have thought long and hard about the Bible, Christianity. That's what I grew up learning about. I have found that it's much more helpful to focus on your life here on earth than what happens after. I think in our history as humans on earth, a lot of focus has been spent on what happens when you get to heaven and do all the things now so that you can get to heaven and you can have this life of your dreams in heaven. And you don't want to be one of the people who ends up in hell, the fiery burning pits with the devil, right? Those concepts don't really make sense to me. A lot of the spiritual learning that I have done has focused on being present in the now, and so I'm not focused on this idea of heaven or this idea of hell. Hell as a concept makes sense to me, that you can be living your own personal hell right here on earth. To me, that would make more sense for you to focus on than this place that you may or may not end up in, and nobody really knows if it really exists, because people who die don't come back to tell us. Like, you understand, like, why do you want to believe so strongly that there is a place where bad people go? Other people's lives don't really have anything to do with you. You can be living the life of your dreams right here, right now. I think if we focus on the now, like Eckhart Tolle talks about all the time, you can realize that you can be kinder to yourself and to others. You can figure out what feeds your soul, what brings you joy, and how can you share and spread that joy? Because I feel like those are the tenets of Christianity that's supposed to lead you to this relationship with God. And the whole idea of Jesus Christ is kindness, loving your neighbor as yourself. And if you are practicing those things now, you don't have to worry about heaven coming or hell coming. This is also why I talk about, I don't think any one religion is the only way to God. I really just see religion as a path leading there, and you create your own spiritual relationship with God. I had a conversation recently with a guy who I think just wanted to be an asshole talking to me about God. Definitely had a fixed way of viewing life and religion and God, and could not see outside of that box. I really enjoy conversations with people who are open to seeing things a different way, or just hearing how another person's personal experience, right? Because I don't agree with everything in other people's religion, but I look at the end result. Are you a kinder person? Are you sharing your gifts with the world? Are you in joy? Is your life full of joy? Is your body happy? Or is your body angry with you? Because a lot of people have bodies that don't like them. Like, are you living the life that you want? But this guy asked me, how do you know? Shareece, how do you know that this way you're talking about? How do you know there's more than one path? Like, how do you know? And I was probably a little cocky on the phone with him, but I'm gonna tell you, one of the things that makes me different from other people is I don't really know. I know. I don't have any evidence, just like there's no tangible, you can't see God kind of evidence. I know based on intuition, I know based on feeling, and I have gotten this mostly through meditation. Secondly, through reading other people's beliefs and how they came to their conclusions. And thirdly, listening to people. If you listen to understand other people's perspectives, you can adjust your way of thinking to see that there might be, right? There might be a different way of being in this world that isn't only centered on the way you think. Because the way you think is very specific to the experiences that you have had. And you have not had all the experiences that there are to have in life. So to me, it's not helpful to focus on this belief in hell as this punishment place. I think instead you can live life right now, being as kind as you can be, and sit with yourself, sit with God, examine your spiritual relationship to figure out, how do you come to the truths that you know about your life? I often tell people, you don't have to believe anything I say. Come on, I could be talking all kind of nonsense. I've seen, you know, some of those videos about aliens and motherboard. Oh, listen, the only point I am hoping to make with my videos is that there's a spark of something that lightens in you. Not that you believe anything I say, but that you experience life for yourself. You can look at the way I'm living my life, right? Because on my videos, I hope it's clear to you how I'm living my life. I'm trying the best that I can to be connected to God, to make decisions based on kindness, on giving. I'm trying to figure out how to share my gifts best with the world, right? I hope that you can see I am truly at peace. I have shared with you the way that I got to this peace. I am telling you, there are a plethora of other ways to get to God, but there's so many paths. The end result, though, is joy. It's peace. And if you have that, if you have meaningful relationships with family and friends, if you have a body that's healthy, a body that can do the things that you needed to do in order to enjoy life most, then do you, boo? Like, don't let nobody else tell you that the way you're doing it is wrong. I'm telling you, if you are in joy, if you are living the life that you want, if you do, I do what I want. I'm telling you, I do what I want. I'm so blessed. I'm so at peace. Life feels so much easier now that I have given so much to God to direct my path. That I just wish this feeling on everyone, because it's so enjoyable. It's just so lovely, and I'm just so thankful. And I hope you enjoyed my video. Subscribe. I do not say this as often as I should. I know that I should, but it really escapes me, and I hate the I hate saying. Subscribe, please, to my channel if you like my content. Share it with a friend, because I'm a blessing. Come on, share with a friend, like, comment, and thank you for watching. I need you to go to the truth that you know about your life.